Hello, my dear students. This is Dr. Jaymin, Department of Physics, Tarsadia University, Bardoli, Gujarat. Today, in this video, we are going to discuss about the integrated circuits that is available in chapter number 23 from the book of Principle of Electronics by V.K. Mehta and Rohit Mehta. I had prepared this lecture notes in the form of PowerPoint presentation for the ease of understanding the topics. Now, everyone has encountered with the different kind of ICs in daily life, or maybe in college, maybe during some experiments. In our computer, you can see in this figure also, there is a processor. It's in the form of the chip, in the form of the IC, or this is the normal keypad IC that is available in market, and you may be used in some experiments also. So today we are going to discuss what is integrated circuits. Before going to the detailing topic, we have to know about some detail which made from this IC. These integrated ICs generally made from different electronics components. So before going to discuss, let us discuss what is that components, that electronics component. Basically, there are two types of the electronic component. One is passive type, second one is active type. There is a distinct difference between these two types. You can see a passive components like resistor, LDR, thermistor, capacitor, inductor, switch, variable resistors, transformers. You have used in your laboratories during the experiment. While active components are transistors, diodes, LEDs, photodiodes, that is ICs, operational amplifier ICs, 7-segment display that is available in watch, batteries. These are called the active components. Now, how these two types of the components differentiate, how they works, what are the basic definition, and how it will used in particular circuits. So let us discuss the difference between these two types of the components, that is active component and passive components, so that you will get a better idea about its working. So these are the difference between active component and passive component. Active component can produce energy to another circuit in the form of voltage or current, as passive cannot supply any energy or cannot produce any energy. While active components control the current direction, but passive components cannot capable to control any current direction. Active component has function to gain for electronic circuit, but the passive component doesn't provide any kind of the gain to the circuits, any gain to the another active devices. Last one, active component used for current control and voltage control application, that is the main point of this active component, but passive component used to only storage of the that energy discharge in the form of oscillations, filter resin, and phase shifting applications. So overall, active component, that is why the name is given, active component is active during the circuit operation, but the passive operation is act as a passive component. It supports, but it cannot contribute to the circuit function. Of course, it supports. So these are the active and passive components used to fabricate integrated ICs. So let's start with the question, what is integrated IC? Integrated circuits, short form is IC. Now these active and passive components, the combination of active and passive component made IC. How? There is a one line definition, one line explanation is transistors to gates, gates to integrated circuit. That means transistor means these are the active component, base with the passive components, they will make a gates, that is AND gate, OR gate, NAT gate. These are the gates available into the electronics, and using that gates we can build a some kind of the logic, we can build some kind of the purpose, and that purpose is known as an integrated circuit. So what are the transistors? Let's go into the brief. An electronic device that used to control the flow of the electricity, electronic equipment with the least three electrodes, a small voltage control, a larger voltage that act as amplifier, act as a switch, that is generally known as a transistor. You have studies in your semester earlier. So the combination of these transistor, the combination of these different combination of these transistor is known as a gate. Transistor and resistor can be arranged in a critical direction output based on the specific inputs, that is known as a logic gate. Because transistor has only two states, on or off, binary system and a Boolean algebra are used to describe the relationship between inputs and output of these gates. So on the basis of these binary numbers 0 and 1. So these inputs to output relationship can be shown on what they called is known as a truth table. So on the basis of truth table, all the logic the levels are defined, and through the logic level the transistor will work. Now the combination of different gates, in this figure we have AND gates, NAND gate, OR gate, NOR gate, NOT gate. There are different gates are available, that is made from the transistor and resistors, and these gates, different gates combine and make a one logic operation. That logic operation is known as a integrated circuits. So in the definition, an integrated circuits having a many components such as transistors, diode, resistors, capacitors in a single package. So all these components are available into the one single package is known as an integrated circuit. Here in this figure I have shown there is a LM555 IC which has a combination of transistor, resistor, that is a trigger circuits, gates, all is available. All these are made on a single chip and they are fabricated for a single purpose. So that is called a integrated circuits. Now how they categorized? Integrated circuits are categorized basically in three ways. One is underlying technology, second one is a scale of integration, and third one is a packaging style. We'll discuss one by one in detail. First, let us discuss the underlying technology, that is TTL, that is transistor logic. Second one is CMOS, complementary metal oxide semiconductor, that is a combination of MOSFETs. TTL is a combination of transistors only. Now what is the difference between TTL and CMOS? TTL is constructed from the BJT, that is the symbol of the typical transistor, that is n-type transistor, and CMOS is a complementary metal oxide semiconductor, and that is made from the FETs. Now what is the advantage of TTL? TTL is a faster, no sensitive to the damage of the electronic devices and discharges, while CMOS uses a lesser power compared to TTL. TTL needs a more power, CMOS needs a lesser power. The disadvantage of TTL is use more power. CMOS disadvantage is it's slower, very sensitive to the damage of the electronic charge. So these are the some disadvantages and advantages of these two TTL and CMOS technology. Now what is, now let's go to the second point, that is IC density and integration. Normally we can call it as a scale of integration. Now on the basis of the component available into the single IC, on that basis we have categorized ICs into the 6 scale of integration. One is SSI, that is small scale integration, that is available for only 10 gates per IC. Basically logic gates are available into that IC. Second one is a MSI, that is medium scale integration. In that integration, 10 to 100 gates available into particular one chip, and that is used to prepare a flip-flop, adder and counter, multiplexer and the multiplexer circuits. Next is LSI, that is large scale integration. In that integration there are 100 to 10,000 gates per IC per chip. So small memory chips, programmable logic devices are possible to fabricate in LSI. VLSI technology, that is very common and you have heard about VLSI technology. So that is the very large scale integration, and in that integration there are 10,000 to 1 lakh gates available on particular one chip. So it can use to produce a large memory chip, complex programmable logic devices for particular task. Next is QLSI, that is ultra large scale integration. In that 1 lakh to 1 crore gates per ICs, and that is used to prepare for some kind of the processors, that is called microprocessors, microcontrollers, programmable ICs, that we can say that. And the last one is GSI, that is a giga scale integration, greater than 1 crore and used for the high end processor, very fast processor, that is that speed is 2.5 gigahertz. So these are the scale of integration. So different number of the gates used to prepare a IC, and that IC is used for particular purpose. So next is packaging type, how the ICs are differentiated in packaging type. So through hole technology, that is one, and second one is a SMT, that is surface mount technology. Surface mount technology is widely used for miniaturization of the electronics. Well proved technology. One is small out IC, second one is a quad flat pack. This flat pack is available mainly used for the programming. These are some for the smaller application. DIP, through hole technology. DIP is dual inline package, that is mostly used for experimental purpose or some smaller applications. Now by using these three, we are going to discuss about the fabrication of ICs in my next lecture. Thank you.